Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Yvonne, also known as Soul Style Beauty, and today I'm back with a life update. I think the last time we spoke, I was on my way to Jamaica for my anniversary trip, but since then a lot has happened. There's a lot of things to update you guys with, so we're just gonna hop in the video. Okay, so let's talk about the trip. So in Jamaica, I stayed at Seeker's Wild Orchid. I loved the hotel. The hotel was amazing. It was adults only. Service was top notch. Food was top notch. They had different cuisines and different restaurants, so it didn't get boring. And the food was pretty okay. It was decent for all inclusive. Forgot to mention that it was all inclusive. And just to add, the entertainment at our hotel was so good. They had a piano bar where you can sing with the pianist. I hope I'm saying that right. And also they had dancers come. They had people play like the steel pan. It was literally something every single day, dancing. So you can honestly just go to the resort and chill on the resort and never get bored. It was that entertaining. As far as excursions, Jose and I didn't get to do all the excursions, but what we did get to do was the Dunn's River tour for the Cool Runnings. It's like a boat, they play music, it's like a party boat, so we did that. We climbed the Dunn's River Falls. We did ATVs, zip lining, we did horseback riding, and we also did the water rafting. So it was a lot. We did a lot of excursions. I recommend each and every one. But in Jamaica, we actually had to cut our trip short. And that is because I tested positive in Jamaica for COVID. And it was just a really hard time for me because number one, we didn't get to do every single thing that we wanted to do for our anniversary trip. So I didn't get to do the dinner on the beach. I didn't get to do our spa trip that day. And I was just really, really torn. Talking about it is just triggering to me because at the end of the day, I was not in my hometown. I wasn't in Brooklyn. So it's not like my family can come over and be like, okay, here's tea, here's this. Because I do like to heal my body in the natural way. But I couldn't even do that because I was in Jamaica. So basically we had to quarantine there for 11 days. And Jose actually stayed with me, which was a risk because he tested negative. So he stayed in the room. We didn't sleep in the same bed. So he was far away from me for 11 days. And I was just lights on the place up, y'all. It was an interesting trip, but it was longer than what we expected. But of course, not for great reasons. So, but yeah, during that time, I was thankful that, like, number one, I had a therapy session down there. So I was like, oh, this is perfect. It's not on Zoom because there was a few things I needed to do on Zoom. And of course, because I was in Jamaica, I didn't have access. But luckily, my therapist is not, like, we don't do Zoom. We do another, like, app. So I was able to also kind of, like, ground myself with my therapist as well. So shout out to Sam. She is literally amazing. And then my husband, like, it gave us a time to really just think about what's important and just to appreciate one another, because literally anything can happen at any given moment. And like this trip, I've never ever expected something like that to happen to me, especially because I was being so careful. Like, I was looking back at the footage of our excursion, I'm like, wow, like, I literally had on my mask, and even still, in a country that cases were below 100, I just had to, it was really important for me to not talk about it as often, so calling everybody under the sun and letting them know what happened, because like I said, it was triggering to me to talk about, and it was a pretty scary thing knowing that I wasn't even in my hometown. It was just so scary. And then sometimes it's like you wake up and you're like, okay, is my symptoms gonna be worse, and would I have to go to the hospital? So to really like balance myself and make sure that I was in the best place mentally, physically, spiritually, I had to get up and just like spend time with God, listen to gospel, and make sure that my faith was staying at an all-time high. And that's literally what got me through that time. So yeah, y'all, it was such a nice trip. I'm gonna enter videos and stuff like that, but it wasn't the best time leading up to the end of the trip, of course. Secondly, as far as career, we can talk about that. I definitely moved into a little leadership position at my job. So I am going to be an instructional coach for first grade phonics. You guys know I'm a teacher, a sped teacher specifically. But one thing I'm going to be doing, and I'm excited to be doing, is coaching teachers for phonics. And this is something I've been doing for 5 years this year. So I'm excited. I feel good about it. I feel comfortable about it. It is going to be a lot more work. But I'm excited nonetheless. And what else can I update you guys with? Oh my goodness. As far as influencing my second job, I'm super happy to announce that I will be working with Minted as a Minted mentor. So y'all, I am going to be working with Minted Cosmetics for a long period of time. This is my longest sponsorship, partnership, and it's just amazing to see. It really amped my energy when it came to influencing, because sometimes you don't know if the support is there, you don't know if people see you. So I was just super excited to have them reach out to me to work with them long term. It's a paid opportunity. And like I said, it just gave me inspo to just create again. Despite what I've been going through on the side with all of that and jumping into work and just being overwhelmed, I just found myself at a stagnant position when it came down to influencing. I was like, do I really like it? Do I not? Like, you know, so I think that me getting this partnership really had me reflect on my why when it comes down to influencing. And I was like, there's still a space for me. I love what I do literally on this channel, and I just gotta keep going, and that's it. That's one period. So I want to thank you guys for watching this video. I want to thank you guys for supporting me, and I hope that you guys enjoyed this little life update. We're gonna get into some real content pretty soon, and just thank you guys. Like, comment down below what you've been up to. I want to hear the good things. Tell me about some milestones and just things that you've been going through. I would love to hear it. And then also things that you want to see from me. And until the next time, bye y'all.